Specialists proudly sponsoring WA Sports.
Hi, I'm Andrew Vlahov. I'm at Kensington Primary School, my old school, and I'm here to take a clinic for some kids. Let's go and have a look.
How you going, Mr. Scott?
Good, thanks, Andrew.
How's things?
Good, mate.
All right, kids. Who's ready to play some basketball?
Come on, then. Let's go.
Quick, lucky last. Off you go.
Go, left hand now. Left hand now. Left hand. Left and right, left and right, left and right.
Okay, little shots in the air. All right. Push it up, up. Okay. Oh, here we go, that's a pro shot, nice.
There's the citizenship awards and that.
And the ducks.
Oh, of course.
The ducks.
Oh, there's my name right there.
There I am. I'm with Mike Scott, my grade 6 teacher. Mike taught me back in 1980, I think it was.
Long time ago.
Yeah, it's just when I started basketball out on those courts. And Mike, are there any more basketballers coming up through the system there?
Yeah, we've seen a big influx. The school's done very well over probably the last 3 or 4 years. We've won the basketball tournament in this district. So yeah, the kids are coming along really well.
So Mike, are there any more rising stars coming up through Kenzie Primary?
Well, there is, but perhaps not as big or as tall.
What about football, soccer, or has basketball sort of taken over?
Probably basketball and hockey are the two that have taken over. But yeah, footy's still played, but not as much.
Mike, you think when people like myself and Crawford and Grayson, they come out to these schools, you think it sort of helps the kids?
Yeah, definitely. It gives the kids a lot of motivation and the skills, and having someone there that's an expert in the field never does any harm. And the kids look forward, actually, every year. I don't think we've missed out since the clinics have started. James, or we've had Trevor here as well, and yeah, it's been really good, and the kids look forward to it each year.
So Mike, since my day here at Kensington Primary, are there any funny incidents that you remember?
Yeah, I can remember when you were in my class, there was you and a couple of other people that I used to give a lot of responsibility to, and I used to go down and say, well, go down and get the sports equipment out, you ready? And evidently, you used to get down to the sports room and have a little bit of a kiss and a cuddle. I found out that many years later.
Well, it's an embarrassed Andrew Vlahov signing off. We're on the prowl. I'll see you next week.
Alignment when they've had a wall up front, it's been very difficult for the opposition to come through, and coupled with Ricky Grace's ability to penetrate and dish the ball, they're in good shape.
Okay, what about tonight's two coaches in the matchup?
NBL telecast proudly presented by Westrack Equipment, Country Holden dealers proudly sponsoring WA Sports, and Chicken Treat. I got the taste.
Welcome to a pumped-up Brisbane Entertainment Centre. I'm Terry Kennedy. And what a clash tonight. Two of the great arch-rivals in NBL history. The home side, the Brisbane Bullets, up against the Perth Wildcats. At the moment, it's 13 wins apiece, head-to-head, Brian Curl. Who will it be tonight?
Big chance for the Bullets. Tough game for Perth last night in Townsville, and they're playing very well, the Bullets, and winning, and that's very important. And with Loggins and Moore and Colbert and Hill all playing well, I give them a big show tonight.
Good confidence boost for the Bullets last weekend, winning the local derby against the Gold Coast.
Yeah, well, that was a tough one. They were down all game, and good teams win these close games, and that's what the Bullets did. And here we see Andre Moore there with a big slam. He had a great game. He's been rebounding tremendously the last couple of games. Pulled down over 40-odd rebounds last weekend. And he's been a real improver this season. Here is another big two-handed slam dunk.
There's no doubt the Brisbane Bullets will have to lift their game if they hope to beat the Perth Wildcats tonight.
Well, they will lift. You know, the standard of the team will lift up the quality of the play, and the Brisbane Bullets know that this is a real big one for them. They want to consolidate that third spot and also stay in the running for the second spot. And you never know what can happen in a few weeks' time.
Well, for the Perth Wildcats, this is the second leg of one of the world's longest road trips. Mike Ellis was in Townsville last night. How'd they play up there against the Townsville Suns?
Yeah, not too bad. It was a bit of a scrappy game, but they got through it. I thought both teams tried very hard, but, you know, they were looking for the nice game, I'm sure.
Mike Ellis, a lot of people have said this road trip so tough, how will it affect the players?
Well, I think tonight is where it's going to tell, no doubt about it. Last night, they was probably looking a little bit past Townsville and got a bit of a shock because Townsville did a good job. So the legs will be a worry for the guys tonight, but I'm sure they're pumped up for a big game.
Andrew Vlahos, he played some minutes last night. How many minutes will he play tonight?
Well, Andrew played very well considering his ankle was a little bit suspect, and again, tonight's going to be the big test for him.
Ricky Grace was the real star for the Perth Wildcats last night with 27 points. Scott Fisher, how hard to stop is he? 25. Two other matches played last night, the Newcastle Falcons 118 over the Geelong Supercats and the Gold Coast Rollers 87, a tough one, Curly, over Canberra.
It was a tough one, Terry, and a great game from Andre Lafleur, 32 points and 12 assists. Sensational game, and the Rollers are still in the race for the finals.
That win did get the Gold Coast Rollers back in the playoff race. Let's check the Mitsubishi Challenge top eight as it stands. Well, the Perth Wildcats with 15 wins really have been the standout performance of the NBL season in 1993. The Brisbane Bullets in third position. What a big game it is, Curly.
Definitely is. And what about the Perth Wildcats? Their road record 8-1, and the Brisbane Bullets, they're right there. Like I said earlier, they need to win this to stay in touch with those top teams, otherwise they'll fall back in the pack with the rest of them there. And down the bottom of the ladder, well, you've got Adelaide 36ers. You've still got a big show. Rollers hanging in there, and the next four teams, they can forget about it.
As we said, two of the great arch rivals in NBL history doing battle, and there's some great matchups. So let's have a look at the starting five as they stand. For the Bullets, Roger Smith with a big defensive job tonight. Shane Hill, Dave Colbert, Leroy Loggins playing with a cracked bone in his foot. Andre Moore, Curly, must have a big game tonight.
Well, he's been playing extremely well, Terry, very consistent. Loggins is the real key, as usual. Dave Colbert, been very consistent. Shane Hill, having a very good season. And like you said, Roger Smith's doing a great job on the defensive end. An unsung hero, really.
Mike Ellis having a look at the Perth Wildcats starting five. Scotty Fisher up against his old coach in Bruce Palmer.
Yeah, I think Bruce will know a few of the tricks from Fisher, but I'm sure he'll have a few up the sleeve left for him, so it should be a good matchup there.
Of course, the benches will also play a very important role as we get down to the wire tonight. They line up Bergen, Trolling, Reefy, Gribble and Blair Smith. For the Perth Wildcats, Watterson, Carroll, Catalini, Davis and Baker. Pretty even then.
Very even, and you can bet your life it'll only be Trolling, Gribble and Smith that'll get any court time at all from the Bullets bench.
Already pumped here at the Brisbane Entertainment Centre. Ricky Grace, who had a wow of a game last night against the Townsville Suns, really has marshalled this Perth Wildcats team. Now Grace. Fisher now gets the first shot of the night away. It won't drop. Andre Moore getting the rebound. Andre Moore needs a big game tonight against the big front line of the Perth Wildcats. He has been in fairly good form for the Bullets, Andre Moore. Hill with the first shot of the night for the Bullets. It goes down.
It was an interesting lineup there, or the way they set up. Roger Smith was playing the point guard spot, and Shane Hill ran off a screen down low and broke free of Ricky Grace.
Hill looks like he'll be freed up to shoot a bit more. Grace tries to make the three-point reply, can't do it. Loggins is on court, he gets up, Smith streaks down court. Now, Andre Moore goes to work on Torrance. Loggins from outside for another three!
Big start for the Bullets. There's Loggins with hasn't trained too much all week, but with a great player like Leroy Loggins, he's got the touch and it doesn't leave him.
Well, off the Perth Wildcats, we're a bit self-conscious coming into this game after playing the Townsville Suns last night. I'm sure they're woken up now, Mike Ellis.
Yeah, a little bit of a nervous start, Terry, I think, from the Wildcats, but I'm sure they'll settle down and they'll have to play some good defence because Brisbane look like they want to shoot the lights out tonight.
The Bullets up by 5 points. Brisbane Bullets ball from the side.
It's an interesting matchup there, Terry. Blahoff's on Roger Smith, so I'd say Adrian Hurley wants to rest Andrew there a little bit.
Yeah. The Bullets, they're on fire from outside. It's 8 points to nil. James Crawford wants to change all that and draws the foul.
Yeah, strong drive here from James Crawford. He likes that baseline move and gets a couple of foul shots here. It'll settle him down. Here you see the replay. He takes it at Andre Moore. Gets him off his feet. Andre Moore, big weakness on his defense, and Moore pushes him in the back and he's packed him. He's done everything there. And so James Crawford's at the foul line now to shoot two.
One of the real veterans, but a real superstar of the NBL, James Crawford, shooting 77% from the free throw line in season 1993, and he makes the first. He had 18 points against Townsville last night. He really has been spearheading the Perth Wildcats team in season 1993. Smith to Loggins. Loggins finds Moore. Moore took the ball over the baseline.
Third ball.
8 points to two. Fisher. Perth looking for a way through. Blahoff. Roger Smith is on his back. Andrew Blahoff gets around and makes a great two.
He didn't look too injured there on his ankle. That was a good move. Very calm about the whole thing. And knew he had Roger Smith on him. Just back him up and turn around. Took that nice, easy jump shot.
Heel out there. The screen set by Colvin. Bumps into Corbin. Colvin, he'll shoot. Andre Moore tidies up. So the Bullets not lacking any confidence early. They're out by 10 points to 4. And the big reject by Moore.
Bruce Palmer happy with that. Makes a little good rebound down the offensive end. Here you see the replay. He beats Roger Smith, Andrew Blahoff, but good weak side help there on the defense by Andre Moore, who swatted the ball away.
Crawford, Fisher left alone all the time in the world to shoot. He'll hurt you all the time.
Yeah, well, Bruce Palmer won't be happy about that.
The Bullets out by four. Roger Smith playing the more point guard role. Heel. Loggins into the action. Blahoff again. But the Wildcats now answer with their reply. 3 points from Torrance. Now just a 1 point ball game. Colvin. Good movement from Roger Smith. Back to Loggins.
Foul before the shot.
Leroy just doesn't look all that comfortable out there at the moment as we watch the replay here. Roger Smith comes over and Loggins comes off the second cutter there and he's fouled. It's now a ball out of bounds play here for the Brisbane Bullets. But Leroy just doesn't look too comfortable in the offense. Just going the wrong spot there a couple of times.
Colbert for three from outside. Knocks it down. Dave Colbert.
Well, two out of two from the three-point line. We know he can shoot. He's hot tonight, Dave Colbert, having a very good season. Ricky Grace makes a nice little baseline drive there.
The Bullets out by 2 points. Dave Colbert, who made a slow start, virtually had an unhappy game against the Gold Coast last Sunday, obviously making amends tonight. Shane Hill, that ball was in, then popped out. Andre Moore gets a second chance and makes it good. So Andre Moore certainly looks focused tonight.
Yeah, well, that three-pointer Shane took just broke the perfect record. Now the Bullets are 4 out of 5 from the three-point line. You don't see that too often at the start of a game.
James Crawford off the glass.
Great soft shot from Crawford off the glass. Moore, turnaround jumper. Andre Moore. 6 points from Andre Moore.
Yeah, well, Adrian Hill will have to make a change there because Moore has got a couple of offensive boards over Scotty Fisher. Scotty's not dropping, blocking him out as well as he should be, and Moore's just putting that little soft second shot up, and a bit of concern there as we see Andrew Vlahos all got checked.
Vlahos, despite the injury, still playing tough. Roger Smith, a near impossible pass to Dave Colbert, failed to come off. Shane Hill picked up an early foul.
That's his first.
Been a blistering start to this game, Mike Ellis.
It certainly has. I don't think either of the coaches would be too impressed with the defensive effort, though, fellas. There's a lot of points up on the board already. I think both coaches will be asking for their players to pull in the defensive straps. Well, 19 shots have been pumped up in just on 5 minutes, so that is a fair clip. Make that 20.
Scott Fisher just doesn't miss from that close range. A two-point ball game. Ball was on the way down. Goaltending call. And Trevor Torrance.
Here we see it here. Dave Colbert, good catch there, but Trevor Torrance knocked it away. But poor transition on defence there from the Perth Wildcats, not watching where the ball was, and that's experience there. Vlahos drew that foul.
Dave Colbert racks up his first foul of the night.
Mike, I'd say looking at this game Bruce Palmer's tactics is to run Perth Wildcats as much as he can because he knows they had that tough game last night and the travel today.
The Brisbane Bullets leading the Wildcats by 19 points to 15.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And the Brisbane Bullets enlisted some pretty heavy help there with the boys from the Inaugura Army Barracks just nearby here to Boondall. They came down from the ceiling, and at the moment, the Brisbane Bullets would have come at the Perth Wildcats from everywhere, including out of the city.
Yeah, well, they want to play an up-tempo game. You can see the tactics here of Bruce Palmer. He wants to run the Perth Wildcats as much as he can in the early stage of this game. After last night's effort up in Townsville, he's hoping that'll take toll on later in the game. What do you think about that, Mike?
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. That's where Palmer can see the weakness of the Wildcats after that long, arduous trip and the game in Townsville last night. But Adrian Hurley was concerned with the defence of the Wildcats. As we mentioned earlier, before the timeout, he feels there's no pressure on the ball, there's no intensity in defence, and he's asking the players to pick that up.
Well, will it happen? It's a two-point ball game. The Bullets up by 2, 19-17. Over the Perth Wildcats. Vlahos goes out there to meet Roger Smith. Trevor Torrance, he's keeping guard on Leroy Loggins. Smith gets through the middle.
Well, that's the defence Adrian Hurley would be concerned about because Roger Smith can't shoot the ball from outside. And you had Andrew Vlahos pressing him up. Vlahos should be sagging off him and make Smith give up the ball.
There, the big battle between Scotty Fisher and Andre Moore for that rebound. And the bullet comes off. Hill now to bring the ball up court against Ricky Grace. Shane Hill well aware of Ricky Grace's reputation, and he always loves to have a huge game. The bigger the reputation, the bigger the game Shane wants to have against his opponent. Loggins can't control the ball on the way down. They'll get another chance from the side, the Brisbane Bullets.
Just by Leroy competing there, he's knocked the ball down off Ricky Grace out of bounds, and the Bullets get it back. They look very committed out here tonight, Terry.
And they're going to have to be. Roger Smith. Loggins. Can't make the shot. James Crawford, the big long arms. James Crawford. Rips down the rebound without any troubles at all. Grace. Vlahos. Back to Grace. Thought about the three-pointer. Now, takes the shot from outside. And makes it good. 3 points to Ricky Gray. It's a one-point ball game here. And the points continue to be rattled up here at a great rate of knots.
Yeah, that was a little smart little two-man game Ricky Grace and Andrew Vlahos are playing over there.
Loggins takes another step closer to the basket. just a bit off range, knocks it back to Roger Smith. Loggins on the baseline for two. Trevor Torrance, back to Grace. Scotty Fisher comes out. Torrance wants to shoot the ball. Roger Smith flew high for the rebound. They realise they must do a good job on the ball. Loggins fouled in the act of shooting.
After the shot there, and it should be a ball from the side there. Eddie Crouch. No, he's called it in the act of shooting here.
Shane Fry on the court taking
touch and go there, but Loggins is on the foul line. He'll be shooting three.
Leroy Loggins, what a record he has from the foul line in season 1993. He's shooting 96%. He's only missed three shots from the charity stripe out of 80 all season. I'll put the big rap on him now.
You do it all the time.
Okay, that's it. I'll just...
The whammy. Well done, mate.
I'll turn in the brief.
It happens every time.
Actually, we've got the top three foul shooters in the competition here in Loggins, Colbert, and Scotty Fisher playing tonight.
Fisher. Loggins made the second. Sorry about that, Leroy. 24 the Bullets. Perth Wildcats 20. Fisher. Blaho. Calling the shots. Not real happy with what he sees at the moment. Scotty Fisher. Ricky Grace tries to continue from last night. What a basket.
That was a great shot, that one, Ricky Grace. And we see Shane Frolling's on for Andre Moore very early in the first quarter.
Heel, the Frolling. Makes his first shot of the night, Shane Frolling. That's a good confidence boost for him.
Yes, a nice basket there from Frolling as we see Loggins leave the floor now and Andre Moore coming back on. So Palmer's using his substitutions here and keeping the pressure up on the big Perth wall.
Now Davis on court for the Perth Wildcats. Frolling. Now Roger Smith streaks away. Gotta make the dunk, Roger Smith.
Very good defense there. Great dunk to finish it off. But Roger Smith playing the lane, denying Trevor Torrance the ball, and finish it off in a great manner.
It really has been one of the unsung heroes of the Brisbane Bulls lineup, Roger Smith. And a couple of injuries this year, but when he's played, he's contributed all the time. Normally in defense, Curly, but he showed all the skills there.
Oh yeah, he's a very athletic player, Roger Smith. He tries hard, works hard. Here you see Trevor Torrance there going on the baseline, gets a foul called, and he'll have two shots when they come out from this timeout.
So with the timeout being called, it's the Brisbane Bullets 28 over the Perth Wildcats 22.
Bruce Palmer there, not too happy with a couple of the referees' calls. David Ingham settling him down. Eddie Crouch said, cool down, Bruce.
It really is a huge game for the Brisbane Bullets because, as we said, really the top teams, they're yet to beat any. With the scoreline, 28 the Bullets, the Perth Wildcats 22. And a sight you don't see all that often, but one that pleased Roger Smith. The big Roger Smith dunk after he grabbed the intercept. Timeout being called. The Bullets are up by 6 points at the moment. Very handy lead with 3 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in this opening quarter. As we said, a blistering start from both teams with Trevor Torrance on the line for the Perth Wildcats. Can he make the second of his two shots? A bumpy old shot. And the guys were in too early, the Brisbane Bullets. Torrance will get, it's not a popular decision here with the home crowd, obviously. Torrance will get another attempt to complete the 2 points. And he can't do it. Well, he's been given a good enough shot at it. Bullets up by 5 points. Heel to Gribble. Luke Gribble on court for the Brisbane Bullets in singlet number 25. Heel. Screen set by Frolling, kicks it back out to Colbert. He wants to shoot the ball. it. Torrance pulled down the rebound. Davis. Lahop will take control now. Tries to go around Gribble. What a tough shot away. Rolling down court. Shane Heal put up the three. And he makes it. What a bomb by Shane Heal.
It was a great shot, but you can put that basket down to Andre Moore. Good outlet. Hit Shane Froling, and Shane Froling saw Shane Heal open, and Shane Heal did the rest with a big 3-point.
Mike, only early days, but trailing by eight, I guess Adrian Hurley, not all that pleased.
No, he wouldn't be too impressed with this. I suppose, as we mentioned a little earlier, Terry, the defensive transition by the Wildcats is certainly slow at the moment, and the Bullets are running them very, very well.
Scotty Fisher from outside. Can't make it. Heal showing good speed down court. Gribble thought about shooting the ball, then thought better of it. I'm sure that pleased Coach Bruce Palmer as well. Froling turns.
Yeah, Froling's been called there for the hold on that move. Real strong move from Froling, but Eddie Crouch right on the spot. And you'll see here, Froling comes in. See how he's hooked Watterson there? Just got a little bit extra leverage. Nice try, Shane, but you just can't do that.
Watterson came off the better of that encounter. Froling. But it will continue.
The players have come off second best this year with Froling.
The big, strong lad made the way up from Hobart, and he's enjoying the Brisbane sunshine. And he's played well for the Bullets. Grace from outside for three. Loggins. Leroy puts the move on Watterson. Cuts through the defense, but couldn't make the basket. Crawford controls the ball well. Rolling. Grace now. A travel call on Ricky Grace.
You don't see that very often. You see Ricky Grace here. Hard to see there with Dave Colvin in the way, but watching, Scott Fisher hasn't really put his authority on this game at this stage.
Colvin, good pass to Andre Moore, being triple team. So Moore's causing some troubles for the Wildcats, as is this man, Dave Colvin. And that's one of the reasons why he's been on fire from outside. Colvin, he already has 11 points, including three-pointers. 34-23, the Bullets out by 11 over the NBL leaders, the pace setters, the Perth Wildcats, with 14 wins against their name already in 1993 as Crawford makes the two, 34-25.
It's a nice assist there from Ricky Grace, made the penetration, saw Crawford open on the weak side and just dropped the ball off to him, and James Crawford did the rest. The Perth Wildcats, a little bit put out here at the moment on their offense. They're bustled. The Bullets are really putting a lot of pressure and denying and not letting the Wildcats get into a rhythm out there on their offense.
Froling. Great move under the basket by Shane Froling. Takes his tally for the night along to 4 points. Watterson back to Fisher. Fisher can't make it off the backboard. Loggins comes away with it. Davis in there trying to spoil the play. Can't do it. Just in the end, Chris Palmer, not too happy with that pass from Shane Froling. He wants some full court pressure being applied. It's a big game. Great. The shot was short. Fisher has the time, can't make it. Loggins.
That's the quarter time.
At quarter time. Well, what a sizzling opening quarter it's been, with the Brisbane Bullets to the cheers of his home crowd. They're out by 36 points over the Perth Wildcats, 25. The three-pointer in the shooting tonight has been absolutely sensational.
Yes, I can't believe this. It's you have four players in the Brisbane Bullets, Froling, Purchase, Heal, and Moore, all on 100%. You see the Bullets are 85% from the three-point line, where Wildcats are only 28. That's great shooting from the Brisbane Bullets. And Shane Heal and Dave Colbert, and overall field shooting, the Bullets 68, The Wildcats are in the high 50s there until the last 3 or 4 minutes, and they've now dropped down to 40%. But that is sensational shooting from the Brisbane Bullets. And not only shooting well, Terry, they're absolutely giving the Wildcats a bath on the rebounding department.
Mike Ellis, any panic in the Wildcats camp at the moment?
No, no panic. Obviously, Coach Hurley was concerned with due cause. But what he's saying is that they just need to keep working at it, and chip away at the lead, make sure that they try and contain the Bullets at this stage. But no real major panics.
A long, long way to go in this game as yet. The Bullets, they'd like to continue the good work they've set up in the opening quarter. The Wildcats love to narrow that gap, and if not lead into half-time. Andre Moore with the turnaround jumper. So he continues the good work.
At least 4 out of 4, so he continues with his 100%, and he's having a great game. I see Watterson come down there and double team away from the ball on Andre Moore, so looks like Adrian Hurley's done a little bit of work here. He hasn't got too much respect for Moore in that dishing the ball out in the low post. We see another steal here from the Bullets. Shane Hill give it to Moore, who finishes it off with a miss layup.
So Moore not quite finishing off that breakdown court. Ricky Grace makes no mistakes. The Bullets are out by 11 points, 38 to 27. Loggins. Heel inside to Coleman. Coleman wants to try and turn Crawford. Finds Roger Smith. Smart play by Dave Colbert.
Well, that came about because Watterson came across from the weak side once more to help. And Roger Smith, instead of standing, he got himself free under the basket and made the easy layup.
Grace can't get the ball inside to Vlahov. Roger Smith is doing a lot of hard work in there for the Brisbane Bullets. Fisher. Crawford. Kicks it back out to Watterson. Scotty Fisher wants to try and get the scoreboard ticking over. Dave Colbert in there fighting hard with Vlahov for the rebound. Brisbane Bullets ball from the side.
Well, the Bullets are going after everything, and what about Scotty Fisher? He's only 2 from 7 at this stage, and wouldn't have too many starts this season like that, Mike Ellis.
No, I must admit, though, he's been struggling a little bit with his shooting, and Scotty's someone that just, as you know, his work ethic is fantastic. He just keeps working at it, and I'm sure he'll pick that up, but obviously a bit of a concern at this stage.
Loggins for 3, yes!
There you see, a 16-point ball game, so Adrian Hurley complaining to the referee there, but it's not the referee that's causing any problems out there. He's got to get this team firing. Their defense isn't working for them, and offensively the Bullets just not letting them do what they want, as we see James Crawford hit his customary little jump shot in the baseline.
43 to 29. We're in for a high scoring game if the Brisbane Bullets can keep up their shooting. At the moment they're shooting 69% from the field, 88% from outside the three-point range. Mighty fancy shooting.
That's sensational shooting, and we haven't seen them shoot like that all year. In that first quarter, they've just come out of the blocks really firing.
Hill, he's way outside.
I couldn't even see the basket from there.
Going for the 4 points. Grace, now Hill tries to stop him. Fisher. Good work by Scotty Fisher after he eventually controlled that ball.
Well, they won't want to let Ricky Grace penetrate too much like that. That's where the Bullets really fall down. They need to stop that penetration from the quick guards.
Loggins, Crawford, in there trying to spoil that play on Colton. Hill wants to shoot the ball. Gets closer to the basket, stripped of it by Ricky Grace. Grace to Vlahov, loses control. Once again, the man to pick it up, Roger Smith. Smith, Andre Moore. Ricky Grace is okay, it was made.
He sacrificed the foul there, Ricky Grace, as we saw Vlahov couldn't pick the ball up. Roger Smith got it and led the charge down here. And Andre Moore just went up the layup, and Ricky Grace has slapped him across the arm. And Andre Moore has the chance now to increase his scoring from 8 to 10.
Not his favourite place on the court. He shoots 64% from the free throw line. Andre Moore makes the first without any trouble at all. And he takes his tally along to 9 points. He's also picked up 7 rebounds, Kyle.
I was just going to say that too. That's a big start for Andre Moore.
Now Grace. He's had a huge season for the Perth Wildcats, Ricky Grace. Gets that step closer.
The Bullets zoned the Wildcats that time down the court, and it's caused a little problem. So they're slow back here on defence once more, and Bullets are really pushing the ball up the court. They're running the Wildcats ragged. As we see here on the replay, Andre Moore goes to the basket. And, he gets fouled there. And Wildcats got no answer at the moment for this quick pace. As we see Blahoff leaving the court, and he's been very rusty. I think that ankle might be bothering him a little bit more than they're letting on. He's only shooting 1 from 5 at this stage.
Moore on the line. Adrian Hurley, Mike Ellis, a coach who prides himself on defense. At the moment, the Bullets have 46 points 4 minutes into the second quarter. There wouldn't be too many teams who have made this sort of start against Perth this season.
No, I can't remember of one, actually. Terry's, you know, Hurley's got to be concerned with that. Not only are they shooting 47 points now, but it's at the percentage they're shooting it, and it's because they're getting wide open, easy shots, and that's something that the defense has to do, is put pressure on them and make those shots tougher.
Watterson gets through the defense on that occasion, and the Bullets 47-33.
Well, on the other side of that, the Bullets probably can't shoot too much better, but the Wildcats can, and their defense can improve. So if the Wildcats do improve in those two departments, well, then we've got a different ball game. So at this stage, it's all Bullets, and it'll be interesting to see if the Wildcats can come back.
We're never satisfied, are we? Grace. Scott Fisher. I don't want to give up too many plays like that. For the Perth Wildcats, plenty of talent, plenty of firepower. They trail by 35-47, but one team can make up leeway quickly. This side can, with the talents of Grace, Fisher, Crawford, Colbert, stripped of the ball there by Fisher. A foul on Fisher. That's his second foul of the night, Scotty Fisher.
As we see Colbert going strong, and Fisher just comes over and gives him a half bear hug there, and nearly gave him a forearm jolt, the whole lot. But Dave Colbert and Crawford having an interesting battle out there, and Colbert's ahead at the moment in that one-on-one duel.
Colbert, what a handy pickup he's been for the Brisbane Bullets. He wasn't the first choice import, of course. He came over late, got here about a week before the season kicked off. And how quickly he fitted into this side. It's been unbelievable, really, and he's been a huge contributor.
He's a great player, and he had a very good 2 years with the Melbourne Tigers before he went back over to America.
Loggins finds Andre Moore. Here come the troops. Dribble. Back to Roger Smith. He was with the Gold Coast Rollers last season. He made the trip up the highway to the Brisbane Bullets. Dribble. Screen set by Moore. Smith shoots the ball. So Roger Smith, he is having a party out there. Have a look at him. Is he having a good time? He has 8 points, Roger Smith.
He's got 4 out of 4. He's taken 3 rebounds, 2 steals, 2 assists, and having a sensational game.
And we'll take a break. Welcome back to the Brisbane Entertainment Centre, where the Brisbane Bullets at the moment, midway through the second quarter. Yes, the scoreline is correct. 51 points already against the Brisbane Bullets name. 35 to the Perth Wildcats.
Foul called on Luke Gribble.
A foul there called on Gribble. It's been an amazing start by the Brisbane Bullets to this game. They've been running and gunning this ball. Their shooting has been superb. Full court pressure now being applied by the Bullets. They don't want to let up. Trevor Torrence, he's away.
He gets fouled by Luke Gribble, and Terry, I reckon the statisticians will be diving for the record books as we see Trevor Torrence go in here, and Luke Gribble fouls him there, and Torrence will have 2 shots. But as I was saying, they'll be searching for the record books here, because the Bulls are well on the way to a 70-plus first half, and I can't remember the last time the team scored so many points. I may be wrong. It could even be in the 80s. I'm not quite sure, but I'll tell you what, they'll be very close to it.
Trevor Torrence can't make the first of the free throws. He's a long-time member of this Perth Wildcats outfit. He won't tire. He'll run all night, this Trevor Torrence. As we said, a big crowd in here at the Brisbane Entertainment Centre. And at the moment, they're getting more than their money's worth from the home side. Shane Frolling puts the move on Torrance. The basket's gone down, the points will count. And now Frolling will go to the line to try and complete the three-point play.
And they're wheeled back inside. Torrance had his hand in his back, and Shane Frolling made a good basket there as Adrian Hurley searching. He's made some subs, pulling Scott Fisher off, bringing Vlahov back into the game, and he's resting Ricky Grace also. So he's trying to find the right combination out there who can really fire his team up, and they need somebody out there to take charge.
He completes the three-point play. I guess when things are going the way of a team, they just keep going that way now. Heel applying the pressure. Watterson gets the ball to Torrance. Crawford loses control of the ball, but the Wildcats will get another chance from the side. Adrian Hurley, he's on his feet, not happy with what he's seeing out there.
The bullets are all over them. They're not even letting them throw the ball in from out of bounds. I wouldn't be surprised if the bullets attacked the Wildcats when they got out of the bus in the car park. This pressure they're applying is very good defensive pressure, and play defense like this, you'll win most of your games. But that's poor defense there. You let Watterson drive through the middle. That's probably one little lap, but overall their defense has been exceptionally good.
It's a 16-point break to the Brisbane Bullets. Over the Wildcats, Dave Colbert, Andre Moore made a great start. Good ball to Shane Frolling. Frolling. So he goes to 10 points for the night, Shane Frolling.
See, the fortunate thing for Palmer at the moment is the fact that with this lead and the way they're playing, he can afford to have Leroy Loggins sitting on the bench, which he has. And if he needs to be later on the game, bring Leroy back in, then Leroy's going to be fresh. But at this stage, he probably won't even have to play Loggins for the rest of the game.
Well, that's a big call.
Well, I'm sure that he'd rather rest Leroy for later games if he knows that this game is wrapped up, although there's a long way to go yet. But Loggins didn't look all that comfortable out there. I know he's had a fairly good start, but he's still feeling a little bit in that ankle, and it's a long season to go yet. And with the finals coming up in October, they'll want to make sure that Leroy's right for them.
Loggins does have a chip bone in his foot. He's been unable to train for the last couple of weeks. He made a surprised appearance against the Gold Coast Rollers last Sunday. I'm not too sure who was more surprised. Bullets coach Bruce Palmer or the Gold Coast Rollers, but in the end it proved a big move because Loggins led superbly for the Brisbane Bullets and they got up against the Gold Coast Rollers in the dying stages.
Shows you how bad things were going. Two Perth Wildcats guys went up for the rebound then and knocked it out of bounds.
Dave Colt flies it off from outside. Pressure still being applied up court. Scotty Fisher just keeps the ball. The alley-oop pass, Vlahov. Fisher off the backboard takes his tally to 10 points for the night.
Curley's calling for a change of the defense now, and we're going to play a little bit of a matchup zone here, and Bullets have still got some good shooters out there in Heel, and you can't leave him open like that.
Watterson came away with it. Still there was three players on him. Gribble follows him down court. James Crawford, quick hands. Vlahov.
Good passing there. Quick movement of the ball, and Andrew Vlahov finished off with a layup. You see Bruce Palmer's called a timeout.
Leroy Loggins, after the timeout, will come back on
both teams. They've had both teams have shot 33 times from the field. And but I agree with Adrian Hurley. He's just given the guys some encouragement. He wants them to keep running, and that's interesting. I thought he would have tried to slow the tempo down a little bit just to take the wind out of the bullet's sail, as you see them in this matchup zone here once more.
Loggins on court. Try to go over the top of Vlahov. Now the Wildcats. Carroll. Carroll makes his first basket of the night.
Young Chris Carroll, he's just come back from the World Under-23 Championships, coached by Gordy McLeod. And Gordy, I was talking to Gordy today on the phone. He has big raps on Chris. He said he had a very good tournament for him and played very hard.
Heel ball inside to Andre Moore. Nice hook shot by Andre Moore. 58 the Bullets, 44 the Perth Wildcats.
Moore's getting the ball too easy down there. That was a good half hook shot there by Andre Moore.
It'll be a Perth Wildcats ball. Dave Colbert just failing to control the ball.
You see the difference on the defence there. The Bullets made it very hard for the ball to get into the post position, whereas down the other end, the Wildcats are letting it get in. They're far too easy.
At the moment, the ball's gone missing. Carroll, bring it in. Scotty Fisher.
Scott Fisher.
Good move, Scott Fisher. Now it's back to a 12-point split at the moment, and 12 points for Scotty Fisher. Smith, heels open, so is Leroy Loggins. Had his foot on the sideline, he's not too happy.
Guys,
48-46. Sorry, mate.
That's all right. I was about to say, they've been shooting the ball from downtown all night. Loggins probably thought he could make one from out of court as well.
He's out in the car park. Race for three of his own. Can't do it. Roger Smith away on the fast break. He has Heal and Loggins with him. Roger Smith makes the layup. Coast to coast. The foul called a Blahoff, so Smith will go to the line.
A three-point play, and the foul's been called on Blahoff. Not happy with the call there. You see there. Blahoff just came over the back, and Ricky Grace probably a little bit unfortunate here. Ricky Grace probably he could have had the charging call, but maybe the referee saw that Grace was underneath the basket there, and you can't set position down there. But Roger Smith, a strong move to the basket.
Looks like a lot of fresh air on that Blahoff foul there, guys.
And that is Blahoff's third foul.
That spells a bit of danger, and Roger Smith still shooting at a 100% clip.
That's near perfect, though.
Yes, if he shoots another one and makes it, it'll be perfect still.
Fisher can't make the hook shot that occasion. Crawford bumps it over the baseline. 61-46. The Bullets out by 15 points. 2 minutes and 31 seconds remaining in this second quarter. Loggins for three more points, and he does it.
Well, I can't understand why the Wildcats will leave a guy like Leroy Loggins open out there in the three-point line. He can shoot the ball. He's been around the league long enough. As you see here, the three-point shooting, 66% to the Bullets, 25% to the Wildcats.
Smith in there trying to grab the rebound. Grace makes a great 2 points. Fisher in there trying to spoil Davis. Will he come away with it? Steve Davis does. Back near his hometown, Davis. He grew up in Oakey, country Queensland.
Big town.
It's a big town. Grace. Davis back to Grace. Now Chris Carroll. Turnover. Bullets will come away. 1 minute and 32 seconds remaining. Up until the break. 64 the Bullets. 48 the Perth Wildcats.
Well, just when the Wildcats looked like they were coming back, the Bullets settled down once more and have weathered it and pushed it out once more to 16 points. And the Bullets are looking very good.
49. With Loggins back out there on court. And settle things down for the Brisbane Bullets. Still turnovers, the Bullets 8, the Wildcats 6, but it's been played at a frantic pace.
Yeah, when you get the game played like this and you push the ball up and you want to run and play the fast break, this is always going to happen. The team will have a fair count of turnovers, but see the Bullets. The one thing that's been very impressive, Terry, is their defensive intensity. It has been very, very good, and they're just not letting the Wildcats get into the flow. And Andrew Blahoff, he's struggling out there. There's no worries, doubt about that. He's not having a real comfortable game at all. James Crawford's gone off the boil as well in this quarter.
Mike, just how tough a trip has it been? I know that I think Perth, what, left Perth at 6 a.m. Thursday morning, and they've had to go halfway around the world to get to Townsville.
Just about. It's a long way. You know, the guys have got to get up at 5 a.m. Thursday morning, get on the plane. They leave at 7 a.m. They fly through to Melbourne, then on to Brisbane here, and they have like nearly a four-hour stopover in Brisbane Airport before they can catch the connection up to Townsville. And they get into Townsville like 8:30 that night, so it's a long trip.
So I guess the downside was stopping over in Melbourne.
Oh, no question. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, it's about time Perth had to do that sort of trip. I remember Brisbane had to go and play in Adelaide Friday night and Perth on Saturday night. That exactly wasn't across the road either, around the block.
Oh, you're breaking my heart, pal. We only do that every single time we travel.
Bit of give and take, isn't there? 64 the Bullets, Perth Wildcats 48. It's a big trip. It'll be even a longer trip home for the Perth Wildcats. If they don't get a move on shortly, they're more than capable of it. Loggins, Smith, Heal. Heal will take the 2 points himself.
It's now 18 points of difference, and Adrian Hill is a little bit off beam there with his telling the players they could be 4 or 5 points down. They're lucky that here they're not 20 points down at half time. And it's been all the Brisbane Bullets, been very impressive, and played very strong and very consistent in this first half.
Roger Smith sticking to Ricky Grace like glue. The wayward pass, Leroy Loggins, he's away, the crowd will like this. Loggins with the dunk.
Big dunk, and there's the 20 points I was talking about with a minute, less than a minute to go in the first half.
A good work, Roger Smith. Back to Shane Heal. Loggins, he'll take three. The shot is touched in flight. He called for the foul. Loggins giving the referee something to worry about, while Scotty Fisher draws the foul at the other end. Dave Colbert is the culprit.
It's Colbert's second foul, and Wildcats moved that ball up. I thought Leroy could have been a little bit of trouble there as well, but he got out of it, and the foul was called on Dave Colbert, and Scotty Fisher has a chance here to bring back under 20 points, and the Perth Wildcats just look completely out of the game at the moment. It's all Brisbane Bullets.
Scott Fisher shooting 89% from the free throw line in season 1993. He had 25 points against Townsville last night. And at the moment against the Brisbane Bullets, Scott Fisher has 14 points. He's tried desperately hard out there for the Perth Wildcats so far in this first half. He needs a bit more help from his teammates at the moment. Moore, Colbert, Crawford. He's not letting Colbert go anywhere. Now Colbert makes a move to the baseline and the basket.
Yeah, he set Crawford up very strong there. Watterson came across to help, but Dave Colbert, he's on fire tonight, and made the jump shot as James Crawford equals down the other end.
And with that James Crawford jump shot, he gets the Brisbane Bullets back to an 18-point split. The Bullets 70, the Perth Wildcats 52 at the halftime break. What a half it's been.
And all these other interesting little solutions, but straight out it's just one versus the other.
So with less than a minute remaining in the first half, the Wildcats lead it by two, 46 plays 44. The Devils with Jim Havrilla, number 35. He brought down a backboard in the recent slam dunk competition, which was contested in conjunction with the three-on-three in Brisbane recently, and had, what, just under 60 stitches.
An enormous amount of stitches from the flying blast that he brought down on top of himself. Let's see what the Hobart Devils will do. Two possessions less, and left there's a foul, and of course, the Wildcats have plenty of fouls to give. They only have one as a team in this quarter.
Havrilla, the fake move around Fisher. The shot is short. Brace the rebound. He has a look up. Sees there's 33 seconds left, inside 30 now. Grace probably looking to make the last play and not give Hobart more than 2 seconds to
I
bring it back down.
I think so, unless it's a give-me layup. for argument's sake, if they free up Crawford or somebody underneath and there's an absolute sitter there, they may just give the ball up.
There's about 3 second differential in the shot clock and the game clock. 7 on the shot clock, 10 in the match. Now, a foul in there. It's just as good, I suppose, John.
Well, it is. Of course, it will give the last possession back to the Hobart team with 8.9 seconds remaining before halftime. Plenty of time to get a shot up. See that foul coming down there from Spaldinas. 100% from the foul line. Ansel, you've pointed this out on the monitor.
I'm not saying anything.
Well, we'll just see whether you're putting the mocker on him here. 4 from 4 so far this afternoon for Andrew Vlahoff.
That front line again this afternoon, very good, Mike. Fisher 14, Crawford 13, as didn't bring it up, but Vlahoff still on 9.
That's right, you got him again.
And he's in double figures, so the front line all in double figures. The clock is running, we've got 7 seconds left in the game. Whiteside and Grace, Whiteside, well done. The dish to McDaniel, McDaniel stripped of the ball, and he'll go to the line.
Well, there you go, within about 28 seconds, we've had 2 possessions. McDaniel will go to the foul line. He was fouled whilst in the act of shooting. Substitutions being made. This is an interesting stuff. Faldina sits down with 1.2 seconds remaining in the quarter. Let's check his foul count. I suspect that's why he's been taken out. That was his 3rd foul when he fouled the other end. Torrance comes in. Watterson, the coaches are at play. They're X-ing and O-ing. 1.2 seconds. If the shot is missed by McDaniels, of course he has 2 to make.
McDaniels so far with 7 this afternoon. He brings it back to a 2-point ball game. But the Wildcats are to win this. They'll have to work hard in the second half. McDaniel in a lather of sweat. It is warm inside. And the second drops. So the clock starts when Crawford, Vlahoff gets the ball. He's tripped. He was fouled. He's appealing for the call.
He's remonstrating with Jeff Schultz about the call. Vlahoff claims that his legs were taken from underneath him. Either way, the scoreline remains the same.
Nothing doing then. And at halftime, it's the Wildcats up by the slenderest possible margin. 1 point, 47 to 46.
Here's a sensational offer from Ian Diffin. Brand new, fully guaranteed steel radial tyres for Laser and Camira size, only $49, including fitting, computer balancing, and new tubeless valve. For large family-sized Commodores and Falcons, only $59, including fitting, computer balancing, and new tubeless valve. So duck off to Diffs today. This sensational offer is exclusive to Ian Diffin Tyre and Muffler Centres. These brand new, fully guaranteed steel radials, complete with expert fitting, expert computer balancing, and new tubeless valve and stem, only $49 the lot for small and medium cars, only $59 the lot for family size, at Ian Diffin Tyre and Muffler Centres.
It's Australian Wool Week, and Katie's celebrate the most beautiful fibre in the world. Soft, warm, pure new wool that you'll treasure season after season. You can't resist the touch and the feeling of 100% wool. Get real wool from Katie's.
That's Katie's, that's me.
I&J introduce caravels. On the outside there's crisp golden crumbs, on the inside thick, juicy fish fillets. But it's in the middle of a caravel that you'll find its real secret. Healthy green broccoli in a smooth cheddar cheese sauce. Succulent prawns in a creamy seafood sauce. So for something more than a crispy outside and a juicy inside, get a spectacular middle. I&J Caravels.
When your throat's feeling irritated and needs refreshing, try Vicks Blue Throat Drops. Extra strong. Extra fresh. Vicks Blue. Extra strong, extra fresh.
When tabloid TV comes to West Beverly...
What do you say? Do I get to be on camera?
Brenda has something to say about everyone.
Well, when I first met her, I thought she was a typical Beverly Hills snob. She's become one of my best friends.
But when they twist her words...
What'd you tell these people, Brent?
Will her friends shut her out for good?
Yeah, David, hi. Is Kelly there?
Yeah, but she doesn't want to talk to you, and frankly, neither do I.
And an offer Steve...
No one will ever know.
...can't resist. 90210, 7:30 tonight on 10.
It's a one-point ball game on day three of the Kmart Classic. The Wildcats up by that point, 47-46. John, at halftime in the previous two games the Wildcats played, they led by 25. This afternoon, they haven't had it their own way.
No, this will really find out what sort of character they have. They're not having it their own way. They were down by five at quarter time. They're up by one at half time. I think the big turnaround has been in their rebounding. They've certainly made a greater effort in that second quarter and a far greater commitment. And boy, the man out here in picture now, he's led by example, Andrew Lahoff.
Very big half, John. 10 points, more importantly, 12 rebounds.
Big rebounds as well. The Ricky man in question there, Ricky Grace as well, he's been closely shadowed by Whiteside. That's been an absorbing contest.
We've spoken at length about Havrilla, as we see Val Dennis make the points there. What about this big man, Havrilla?
Havrilla's done well. Best game so far, 13, and he's only got one rebound. That's the weakness in his play, and he's not very quick or mobile, having a difficulty really matching up with people like Fisher.
Blaha, probably the player of the first half, along with Crawford for the Wildcats. There's the situation quarter by quarter. The Devils led at the first change by five. At halftime, they lead by one. The Wildcats, that is.
Well, the Wildcats with a 46% shooting percentage would be concerned, because whilst they would look at a season of 50, in the preceding two games they've been well over that 50% shooting margin, and they're well down from three-point range. Put that down to some tough defense from the Devils. And rebounds, I don't think they're quite right. Our monitor shows it's about 28-19 in favour of the Wildcats, and that's where the game looks like being won or lost.
Let's go through the individual scorers then, and that front line for the Wildcats, all in double figures. Fisher with 14, Crawford 13, and Vlahov 10. That threesome had been very much the story of the weekend here. Torrance 6, Grace 4, while for the Devils, Havrilla, his best performance this weekend with a double figure as well, 13. McDaniel's got 9, Val Dennis 9. There's some big bodies there. Stewart 5 and Turner 5. What about the second half, John? How do you see the game panning out?
Well, I think it now will be a test on the ability of Hobart to hang on. Cal Bruton, just before half time, was really getting into his charges out there and telling them they was laying down just a little bit with their intensity. I think the Wildcats really have to come out, and the first 5 minutes of the next quarter could well decide the outcome.
Okay, thanks for that then, John. So it's a one-point ball game at halftime. The Wildcats up by one, 47-46. We'll take this break, then be back with more from the Entertainment Centre shortly.
And I wouldn't mind. That you wouldn't mind going, going along with my plan. When it will be right, I don't know. What it will be like, I don't know. We live in hope of deliverance from the darkness that surrounds us. Hope of deliverance, hope of deliverance, hope of deliverance from the darkness that surrounds us.
It's Australian Wool Week, and Katie's celebrate the most beautiful fibre in the world. Soft, warm, pure new wool that you'll treasure season after season. You can't resist the touch and the feeling of 100% wool. Get real wool from Katie's.
That's Katie's, that's me.
Big
Mistake! Carpet Liquidators are overstocked after making an Eastern State bulk scoop purchase. Yes, all 13 Carpet Liquidator stores are forced to have a $2 million carpet clearance. Management says liquidate these carpets now. Burble Wool Blend, $49 per metre. Luxury Plush Pile, $47.50 per metre. Twist Pile, $45. Sculptured Fine Denny, $39. Hard-wearing Burble Look, $33 per metre. There's no price mistake, so rush to Carpet Liquidator's $2 million carpet clearance. Make no mistake, all carpets must go.
I thought you said we were going to catch one of those great new fast-track trains today.
We are. This is the easiest way to do it from here.
What? From a bus stop?
Look, from here, with just one ticket, we can use the new TrackLink bus service, which will take us right into the interchange in time to catch a fast-track train to the city. Here we go.
Gee, Barry, the ride on these trains is as smooth as a bus.
Dave, how you ever became a brain surgeon, I'll never know.
Thinking Kane Furniture, Cushions and Accessories? The answer is Kane World, the biggest range of quality, affordable Kane furniture in Perth. Kane World can make new cushions or recover your old ones from over 400 quality stock fabrics, discounted up to 70%, and now selling at only $10 a metre. Yes, $10 a metre. Right now, Papasan cushions are only $29 single, $59 double. Incredible Kane World value from two huge showroom warehouses. 164 Balcatta Road, Balcatta.
Now at Tom's Tyres, just $49 will buy you a brand new premium quality tyre. Made by Australia's largest tyre manufacturer, including fitting, valve and balance, and a 40,000 kilometre warranty, all for only $49 each. Or pay only $210 for four, including a wheel alignment. So buy them for just $49 each, or save up to $131 on a set of four.
But only from Tom's Tyres.
A burned-out cop on the trail of a killer.
Wanna know how we catch her?
Seduced by her beauty.
I believe in animal attraction.
Blinded by passion.
I believe in this.
Academy Award nominee Al Pacino.
I have done some desperate, foolish things.
With Ellen Barkin.
You mean like being here with me?
And Roseanne's John Goodman.
Just walk away.
For the first thrilling time on television.
What are you looking for?
8:30 tonight, Sea of Love on 10.
Still a half-time of the entertainment center. The Wildcats up by one at the big break, 47-46. Well, last year, our production people at Channel 10 put together an award-winning clip featuring Grease Lightning, a compilation of highlights from 1992.
Dashboard and doom up the twins, oh yeah. With new pistols, clubs and shots, I can get all my rocks.
Yes, great piece that, and good to see our sideline commentator Mike Ellis feature amongst the highlights. Now to our Sega Slam Dunk competition, being staged in conjunction with the four divisions of the Kmart Classic being played around the country.
It's the Kmart Classic Sega Slam Dunk competition, where you have the chance to win this fantastic Sega Master System 2 and Basketball Nightmare game. We'll show you the finalists in the Kmart Classic Slam Dunk competition, pick who you think will win the final next weekend, and phone the 0055 number on the screen. Now, here they are. Dunk A is Brett Rainbow from the Melbourne Tigers. What style, Brett? And they say white men can't jump. Our second dunk is from Neil Turner of the Hobart Devils. It's the one-handed slam. Dunk C features Adelaide 36er Brett Wheeler with a reverse slam. Let's see that one more time. And finally, Everett Stevens from Newcastle wowed the crowds with this dunk. Nothing can beat that, hey Terry? Here are the 0055 numbers again. Simply pick which player you think will win next week's Slam Dunk Final, ring the corresponding phone number and register your name. Be watching Sunday Basketball next week from midday to see the Slam Dunk Final and to find out if you're the winner of the great Sega Master System 2.
Well, in Perth, John, you voted for Neil Turner of the Devils. How does he rate amongst the other three?
Well, I guess it's all to be unfolded next weekend. Turner certainly won it comprehensively here, but Stevens looked pretty good too with that reverse one-hander.
Okay, let's go to Mike Ellis now, standing by on the sidelines. Mike, a one-point ball game at halftime. How do you see the second half?
Well, I think the Wildcats having trouble getting out of bed this morning, obviously. They didn't start as well as they have in the last two games. Second half will be a big game for them. I'm sure they'll come out firing. Hobart are playing well, though.
They've done it well, John, haven't they? They've matched the strength department, really, with the Wildcats underneath the bucket.
Well, they have, and we made comment of this throughout the weekend, that the Hobart, that is, the only team that's been able to match up and match up consistently against the team of the Wildcats' front line. But it's all to be won right here, and the first 5 minutes are usually vital in these ball games.
So 47-46, we await the Wildcats to come out. There's Vlahov, Torrance, Grace, Crawford and Fisher. The Devils going with Valdenis, Havrilla, Stewart, Turner and Whiteside in the backcourt there. So a one-point ball game. Over the weekend, the Wildcats have been in charge of their games by halftime, but this is a different proposition. They'll have to fight hard for victory. And Crawford, as he does so often, he gives the Cats first use of the ball. Torrance out wide with six.
First possession favours the Wildcats. Let's see if they've got a set play from the sidelines. Grace will inbounds the ball. Torrance loops and comes to the top. Pass is not there. Fisher, Vlahov. Grace comes with a left hand off the glass.
And Grace goes to 6, 49-46. Michael Ellis, how are the players holding up with this demanding schedule this weekend?
There's some big players going here. There's Whiteside with a great drive over the top of Crawford. That was a great shot.
Grace tried to steal the ball and paid the price. Whiteside was too slippery.
The Whiteside has four then. Grace gets past Whiteside baseline. What a magical move that was from Ricky Grace.
As he does so often, that's the payback. Stung into action at the other end of the court.
The Cats lead it by three. And here's Whiteside. What can he do? Turner doesn't mind the long-range shot. Crowd will and truly in this game in the second half. Havrilla. This will be an interesting jump ball. Ricky Grace and Havrilla.
Well, let's put your odds on this, Peter Ansell. Grace came down, doubled down and helped. Havrilla showed the ball and that was just enough for Grace. Havrilla comes inside. There's Grace with the ball. Little slowness there from Havrilla.
There's a similarity.
I got an outside odd on Grace.
We'll have to go early. Well, don't put your money away, Michael.
Close but no cigar.
Havrilla's a name like a cigar. Sounds like a cigar, actually.
Close wasn't even on the court either.
No. Actually, I was comparing Havrilla's head with the ball. I was having trouble differentiating the two.
Back to the action now. This guy's had a good game, Whiteside, and Grace is really giving him a lot of respect.
Stewart goes to Valdenis. Vlahov in his face. Whiteside gets past Grace. Nice dish that to Valdenis. He got rid of Fisher and then makes the basket.
51-50. Still a one-point margin in favour of the Wildcats.
Tommy Mills calls the foul. 2-5. Whiteside. Fourth foul for Whiteside.
So Grace with the inbounds play to Vlahov. He's been very good with 10 points. Crawford has 13 in the half. Now there he goes, Crawford, off the glass. Not that time. As Val Dennis drags down the board.
Good defense from Turner then.
Whiteside. What a dynamic move that was from Gracie's. Very quick himself. Had no match to Whiteside then as he took him on the left-hand side.
He's done that three times and got through for layups each time. It's a good strong move. Grace is slow to move there. Good strong move from Whiteside. Rather desperation at the finish with the shot. So he'll be watching it again. Little jink to the right, then go to the left. Grace will let him get that first step. Of course, the most worrying part about that is the lack of defensive help. But I think Whiteside's been able to dish the ball off so effectively, the helpers have been a bit concerned about being hurt.
Now Grace at the other end. Gets around Whiteside. The dish to Fisher. Fisher throws up the shot. Doesn't get the roll. And Havrilla, the rebound. And now the Devils bring it back down. They lead by one, 52-51. Here's Stewart. Low post, Havrilla. Val Dennis through the keyway, and that's a travel.
Little extra step on the walk there. Val Dennis not happy. He's put the ball down. The Hobart bench is not happy either.
What about the small man's game, Mike? We saw Bobby Luck cut from the Geelong roster. We've got Grace and Whiteside. Whiteside, probably the smallest player in the league.
He would be at this point, without a doubt. And the thing is, there's still a place for them, Peter. It's just a matter of you can't have too many of them.
Torrance gets the roll. And Torrance goes to eight. And the Wildcats back to a one-point lead in a fluctuating game here.
Well, almost 3 minutes expired, 2.5 in this third quarter. Hobart responding.
The Wildcats by one, 53-52, and we've got a
damaged floor.
Well, I was going to say, we should have called out timber, maybe.
Havrilla taking a dive here. Crawford gets the ball, makes the effort to avoid the contact. Havrilla really goes down on one of the 10 pins, but just a little bit too late.
You're supposed to call out timber when that happens.
Yeah.
Three
foul.
Three people fell off their chairs on the Wildcats bench.
Torrance across court. Fisher thought about the three. Goes baseline, runs out of room. Vlahov left open. This is a triple. Now Fisher gets it back out to Grace. That was sweet.
Good strong ball movement there. Cross court from Fisher. Fisher was double teamed with Spaldinas and Havrilla.
So a 4-point ball game. Wildcats shooting 33% from outside. Grace in double figures now with 11. He's guarding Whiteside here. Havrilla with 13. Now there's Whiteside. No good. The 3-point attempt. Vlahov has 13. Rebounds now. Grace, nice dish that inside to Fisher.
Good vision. Found Fisher unattended, and of course the quick transition down the floor meant that Havrilla really couldn't get back to cover Fisher. Got a timeout by the look of it. Scoreline favours the Wildcats, 58-52, and both clubs want to talk about it.
Champs back for a third night, but with something to get their teeth into.
Catherine.
What is a choo-choo bar?
What are minties?
What is a violet crumble bar?
Yeah, that's right.
They're all going for it. Jeopardy. Take the challenge. 6 o'clock Monday on 10.
And that timeout called by Cal Bruton. The Wildcats lead it by 6, 58-52.
Southern Sound and Mad Marty Surfwear doing it together. Mad Marty's have got all the happening surf gear of the season. New arrivals regularly with the best labels, best range, and definitely the best prices on all surf clothing, ladies' wear, kids' gear, wetsuits, and accessories, along with Southern Sound, Albany's number one music superstore. Offer the best selection of CDs and cassettes in the Southwest. There's something for everyone, along with accessories galore. So for all surf and sound, head no further than Mad Marty Surfwear and Southern Sound, the ultimate experience.
McIntosh met heavily. McKenna knocked to the ground. That's a terrible fall.
Sports injuries can sideline you for weeks or even worse, but you can beat sports injuries if you follow these three simple steps. First, warm up before you play sport. Second, stretch before and after you exercise. Third, cool down after any activity to minimise stiffness and improve recovery. If you want to know more about how to beat sports injuries, you can get this information by phoning the Arthritis Foundation Sports Injury Info Line on 008 011 041. And remember, we can all beat sports injuries.
The Brisbane Bullets are up by 70 points over 52. And Mike Ellis, no doubt Adrian Hurley had some well-chosen words at half-time for the side.
Yes, very concerned at this stage. You know, I see two areas that they're falling down at this point. The first is defensively. They're just not making or forcing the Bullets to do something different. The Bullets are able to do whatever they want, whenever they want. Secondly, down the offensive end, the Wildcats are in too much of a hurry to try and bridge this gap. They need to move the ball around and get a good shot rather than hurrying that first one.
I agree with you there, Mike, but the reason they're hurrying is because the Bullets' defense is just pushing them at them and making them play at the Bullets' pace, and that's not what the Wildcats want to do. They need to slow it down a little bit, just take the air out of the ball for a while and just see if they can get the tempo, their tempo.
They also need to make a good start to this third quarter. That is not the sort of start the Perth Wildcats would have been hoping for. Losing the ball out of bounds. Now Heal. Brisbane Bullets, they lead by 18 points. Can they keep up the intensity from the first half, the home side? Moore did well to control that ball. Roger Smith, who had such a big first half. And Crawford called for the foul on Andre Moore.
Yeah, well, Crawford for once was trying to deny Moore getting the ball down that low post position. And as you see it here, Smith feeds it in, and you just don't quite see it there, but Crawford must have fouled him just before that shot, but at least he's making some effort there to deny Moore getting the ball.
Trevor Torrance trying to stop Loggins. It's a hard task. Leroy Loggins goes along to 16 points for the game so far. Loggins. Torrance inside to Fisher. Fisher through the traffic. And Andre Moore rips down the rebound. It's a 20-point break to the Brisbane Bullets. Andre Moore racks up the points. 74-52 defensive rebounds. The Bullets 15, the Wildcats 9. And that is one of the jobs that Bruce Palmer set his side during the week. They had to get up there and work hard on those boards.
Well, they're dominating that area, as you see Ricky Grace get picked up here for a foul for halfway on Shane Heal. But they're dominating in every facet of the game, shooting, defensively, on the boards, and their overall play. It just, there's no weaknesses at all in the Bullets game at this stage.
They're out by 20. Loggins, Heal. Ricky Grace, he's yet to cut loose. Heal goes over the top of Grace. Fisher was in there, but Colbert comes away. Bullets will get a second chance. Roger Smith through the traffic. He just strolled through there.
Well, Mike Ellis said that Adrian Hurley wanted to pick up on their defence, and that was Matador defence there. Just let Roger Smith go through. And the one thing, you know, the Wildcats just aren't putting enough thought in their defence. Roger Smith is not a shooter from outside. He's a driver, and they need to get off and contain him outside.
James Crawford takes his total along to 12 points for the night. Smith. Brown Blahoff. Now Coleman loves to shoot the ball. That's one of the reasons why.
There was no pressure at all on the Bullets. They're just shooting the ball whenever they want to. And Adrian Hurley, he just sat back there. I was watching after that shot. You see the Wildcats were there struggling to get their shots off and to get a shot away, with the Bullets just all over him at every opportunity. And Adrian Hurley, he just doesn't know what to do here with the team. I'm sure he'd know what he'd like to do, but Adrian's very concerned, and really there's no blame can be pointed at Adrian Hurley. It's the players out there that just don't seem to have that intensity at the defensive end.
Andrew Blahoff on the line for the Perth Wildcats.
Well, they're not even making foul shots, Terry. This is not the Perth Wildcats that we expected here tonight. The number one team in the nation, leading the competition by one win over the Melbourne Magic. But good teams will come back, and it'll be interesting to see what sort of quality the Perth Wildcats are made of.
Smith, Heal, Colvin. The Bullets are really combining. Just ask the Wildcats. Brisbane 80, Perth 57. Blahoff, all the moves. Smith in there trying to spoil the play. A popular call, the ball going away for the Brisbane Bullets.
Just nothing's right going for Andrew Blahoff. He's having a shocker tonight, and I'd say his ankle is bothering a lot more than what a lot of people would think.
Colbert for the two, a one drop. I'll get another go. Smith went to drive. Loggins for three. Fisher comes away. More down there applying pressure. Crawford to Grace. Grace puts the step on Shane Heal. Blahoff. Moore's on the back of James Crawford. Crawford tried to draw the foul, but with the fake, got an accidental knee in the side.
And that just adds a further weight to the Perth Wildcats, as we see here. Crawford, he gets Roger Smith up, he gets Andre Moore up, and Andre Moore giving him a knee in the back, but can be quite painful. Here we see it here once more. Here Andre Moore is up there, but great fake there. And it's an object lesson there to young players watching James Crawford, how to get the defense off their feet and take that ball up to the hoop. But James Crawford, he's fairly tough. Probably lie there and get a bit of a rest and a bit of a rub, and be back on the court and ready to play.
33 years of age, a real warhorse for the Perth Wildcats. Sometimes those corks can prove painful. Looks like he's going to have a bit of a break. James Crawford, Eric Watterson will be coming into the game for Crawford.
Taking out the injured James Crawford.
Points for Bullets, the Perth Wildcats 59. Heal over to his captain in Loggins. Colbert. Colbert, the turnaround jumper. And the foul's being called on Torrance.
Dave Colbert, the last four shots he's taken, he's had all the time in the world to get the shot away. That was probably the most pressure he's had on him all game, and a foul was called there on Trevor Torrance. But Dave Colbert's having a big game. He's the game high scorer at this stage with 19 points, and makes these. He's into the 20s, and Dave Colbert has been the real find for the Brisbane Bullets this season.
Mike, we were saying before that the Bullets haven't really beaten a lot of the big name guns in season 1993. The Perth Wildcats are really the measuring stick for any side, and this was really Brisbane's acid test. I guess so far you'd have to be impressed.
Oh, no question about it. They've come out. The thing I've been impressed with, Terry, more than anything, is their defensive intensity. You know, I think people have questioned the Bullets' defense in the past and calls that as perhaps one of their weaknesses. But tonight, I've found no fault in it whatsoever. They're just not letting the Wildcats do anything.
Blahoff makes a great two off the backboard. Blahoff, troubled by a bad ankle, still out there battling away, and he has 9 points.
To add to that, we've got James Crawford on the bench getting treatment over there from the physio. So things aren't, nothing is going right for the Wildcats at all. A shame. Peel puts one up there and
Grace. A little goose step in there from Grace. Blaho. Bishop Watterson, good hands back to Blahoff, who makes the two. And Roger Smith, he's going to be exhausted after this game. He's been everywhere.
Roger Smith had the best game of his career with the Brisbane Bullets tonight. He's hit 6 out of 6 for 13, made his foul shot. He's had 5 rebounds, 2 steals, 3 assists. Everything's going right for Roger Smith.
He made his debut in the NBL for the Bullets in 1989, then he played seasons 91 and 92. Loggins, what a miracle shot!
Ball for the foul, wasn't there. Leroy Loggins just shows you, when you're hot, and the Bullets, I reckon they could throw up any shot they like and it would go. As a travel's been called on Scotty Fisher, and it's just the opposite for the Perth Wildcats. They can't do anything right, Bullets can't do anything wrong.
I think if you saw the look on Scotty Fisher's face, it really did tell the story for Perth Wildcats tonight.
Yeah.
84-63. The Bullets, they're out by 21 points midway through the third quarter. Colden, Peel for 3 points, yes! Watterson to Fisher. Scotty Fisher is just having an unhappy night.
Yes, Scotty Fisher just can't get the ball to Morfer, and this is probably the first error the Brisbane Bulls have made for I can't remember when the last one was, and that's the easiest basket the Wildcats have had all night, that layup there for Ricky Grace.
87 the Bullets, 65 the Perth Wildcats. Loggins works the baseline to perfection, Leroy Loggins, and he bumps his tally up to 20 points for the night. A timeout being called for Brisbane Bullets. They lead 89 points to the Perth Wildcats 65.
Husband and wife, secret agents, coping with family and passion and the dangerous world of espionage. Undercover, 1:30 Monday, Wednesday and Friday.
WA Secondary Agricultural Schools and Colleges prepare young men and women for employment in agriculture, natural resource management and allied industries. Agricultural College graduates can continue on to Muresk Institute of Agriculture to undertake associate diploma and degree courses in agribusiness, marketing and farm management. Agricultural education, the pathway to a satisfying way of life.
At Discount Auto Parts, we are the brake and exhaust professionals. Leaky mufflers are dangerous, so bring your car in, we'll give it a free exhaust inspection, and if you've got a problem, we can supply an exhaust to fit any make, any model. And it's too late to have your brakes fixed once they've failed, so come in, see my professional team at Discount Auto Parts and have a free brake test.
See the professional team at Discount Auto Parts in the Big Blue Building, Blair Street, Bunbury.
Welcome back to the Brisbane Entertainment Centre, where at the moment the Brisbane Bullets lead the Perth Wildcats by 89-65 midway through the third quarter. Ricky Grace must kickstart this Perth Wildcats outfit shortly. Blahoff, he's another man who can do it. Watterson thought about the three, gets it to Fisher. We'll get a second chance from the side, Mike Ellis.
Yes, there's a bit of a concern here. I think Adrian Hill is a bit concerned the fact that the Wildcats aren't exerting the physical presence, and they have a physical presence here, they're just not doing it. Whereas you go down the other end and the Bullets are just pushing the guys wherever they want to go. So he wants a better effort from that area.
What's the story on Crawford, Mike?
He got a bit of a knee in the hip by the look of it. It's a bit of a, you know, you get a cork in the leg. Well, you can do the same thing on the hip. You get a bit of a pinch on that area there. just he's getting a bit of work there, but I think you'll find that he'll be out there shortly. He's just a little bit tender in that area.
Ricky Grace now. Grace has 15 points. He's following up his good game against the Townsville Suns last night. Blahov. Charge called on Blahov. Dave Colbert had position. Blahov not too happy about it. I think that's his fourth foul.
Here we see it here. Dave Colbert there caught. Blahov is really charged in here. Although, you know, probably a little bit dubious there if he had position, but the referee sees it in the favour of Dave Colbert, and once more, just good defensive play from the Brisbane Bullets and frustration from the Wildcats trying to force things.
89-65. Hill, Andre Moore charges through the defence. Moore, he's pumped up. He takes his tally along to 18 points. He continues to shoot 88% from the field.
Ricky Grace keeps battling away from him too. Here's the pick of the Wildcats players out there. See quick transition. Andre Moore, easy layup. Good look from Shane Hill. And the Bullets are just, you know, I don't want to be too critical of the Wildcats. It'd be hard. They had a tough game last night and all that travel. But just playing into the Bullets' hands at this stage.
Hill. That was for 2 points. Dave Colbert came flying in. Fisher gets the ball to Blahov. Back to Fisher. Carroll. And the charge called on Carroll. Referee rules. Rolling head position.
See here, Chris Carroll takes it to the basket. Shane Brolling's there, and Carroll's called for the charging foul. That's two charging calls in a row on the Perth Wildcats.
So now the call's starting to go against the Perth Wildcats as well as the scoreboard. The Bullets leading by 93-67. Mike Ellis, it's the Perth big men that have troubled most sides around the country all season. Really, they thought they were going to give the Bullets one hell of a time. It just hasn't turned out that way.
It certainly hasn't. I think it's been in the reverse, if nothing else. Andre Moore has really stamped his mark on this game, done a fantastic job shooting-wise, rebounding-wise, and defensively as well. Dave Colbert's just filling it up from all over the place as well. So, you know, the reverse has happened. The Wildcats' wall has somewhat crumbled a little bit tonight. But that's something that they've got to try and regain a bit of focus on. There's still a long time left in this game, and they need to get back on track.
I feel a bit, you see the fouls that's quarter, Wildcats 5, Bullets 1. I feel a bit for Adrian Hurley, Mike. I worked with him for 4 years with the national team, and Adrian's a very good coach defensively, very good coach overall, but his defensive philosophies are very strong. And he'd be at wit's end here to understand why his team, as we see him here trying to geez players up and really get them fired up to play that defense. But Adrian really drums into his team's defense, defense. And tonight, his players just can't give him the answers that he wants on that defensive end. And Adrian will be disappointed here because, you know, he knows that he's got the team that can play defense. But sometimes the coaches just can't control that little machine just above the shoulders on players.
Well, that's the hard problem, isn't it? Curly, you'd know that. You can't actually get out on the floor and do it yourself. You can tell them and tell them, but if it doesn't get done, then that's about all you can do. And he's tried to rotate different players and try different things, but, you know, the players have to put that input in, and it's up to them to work it.
I agree, and you see he's changed his defense up here once more with this zone, and they're matching up here on it. He's tried everything he can with his players to try and get them motivated on that defensive end.
Roger Smith scrapping for the ball once again. Loggins for three. James Crawford back on court for the Perth Wildcats, and he takes the rebound. Crawford again. Blahov. Good ball to Chris Carroll. Once again, Carroll denied. Roger Smith streaking up court. Andre Moore collapsing concentration. And the call has gone the way of the Brisbane Bullets.
Teams are playing well, and there's a 50-50 call coming up. You can always bet your life the team that is playing well out there will get the breaks.
Loggins for 2 points. So Loggins, chip bone and all, no practice and all, still has 22 points against his name. Grace, Vlahov, quick hands back to Grace. Off the apparatus for the bullets ball.
The way Leroy Loggins is playing, I believe Bruce Palmer might be inclined to let him not train for the rest of the season.
It's a handy way, isn't it?
Not too shabby, I must admit. He's having a great game.
He certainly is, and Bruce Palmer's probably not happy with Shane Hill. He's the only player shooting less than 50% out there, Shane Hill.
I think he'll have to be working on that at training next week.
Now, through Watterson, the Wildcats come away. Chris Carroll at the top of the keyway. Crawford, the hand in there from Loggins. He says, I got the ball. Yes!
You see Crawford goes past Froehling. Froehling probably a little bit cautious there. He didn't get the foul called on him, but Loggins had the hand in there, and James Crawford drew the foul there on Leroy Loggins. The Wildcats take it from out of bounds. Luke Gribble comes in for Shane Froehling.
So it's a 28-point lead to the Brisbane Bullets. Grace, Laho, now James Crawford. The Wildcats, they need someone to spark. Crawford has 16 points. Andre Moore off his foot.
It's probably Andre Moore's and Leone's blemish for the game tonight, that turnover there, but Bruce Palmer now, he'll be concerned, he'll want to keep this intensity up for this, just under 2 minutes in this quarter, but also that last 12 minutes, they want to make sure that they leave this game with that psychological advantage over Perth Wildcats.
Now, Baker on court, the Perth Wildcats. Crawford, good move, James Crawford.
Crawford's their leading scorer now with 18, and showed a bit of determination there the last couple of times down with going to the basket strong. And
once again, the loose ball ends up in the hands of the Bullets. Andre Moore completes the 2 points and will go to the line for three. Leroy Loggins is out there getting the team together, saying they must keep this advantage.
There it is. Andre Moore just got up there, got the big strong offensive board and took it up and drew the foul, and he's having a big game, 22 points and 9 rebounds.
Andre Moore had about 7 of those rebounds after 6 minutes. And a huge opening to this game. Shane Froehling, Andre Moore earns a rest. Froehling comes on.
Andre has got 23 points. 23 for Andre.
Watterson, Fisher. Gribble's out there for the Bullets. Crawford. A blocking foul has been called on Dave Colbert.
Dave Colbert. His third. You've got to stop.
Here we see Crawford makes a strong move here. Dave Colbert's moving there, and there's no doubt in that call there by Billy Mildenhall on Dave Colbert.
Grace, bring the ball in. Watterson. Fisher. Crawford goes over the top. Crawford can't make the basket. The Bullets come away. Heel. Colby. Froehling. Loggins wants it. Shoots it. Fisher comes away with the rebound. Now Grace. Watterson. Loggins in there trying to spoil the play.
30-second clock is reset.
98-73. The Bullets in front. 35 seconds remaining in this quarter. That ball went straight to Froehling.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that'll get in an assist or a turnover, but I'm sure I'll go on the turnover column. But it just shows you, you know, how the Perth Wildcats are playing. And this is not a true indication. I wouldn't get too carried away with their performance tonight, although don't take any away from the Brisbane Bullets. They've been a dominant team in this competition here tonight.
They dished it up to the Wildcats early, the Bullets. They've failed to recover. Loggins just continues to hurt the Wildcats. Watterson, 1 second left on the clock before the three-quarter time break. You better make that 0.2 of a second. They've cracked the century barrier, the Bullets. They're 100. They lead the Perth Wildcats 73. The pass from Grace bears no fruit. The Bullets 100 at three-quarter time lead the Perth Wildcats by 73.
He's powerful, he's compassionate, but most of all, he's human. The Commish, every Tuesday night at 11:20 on GWN.
See you later, mate.
See you, Dad. Can I come too?
Sure. When you're older. See you tonight.
Gee, I wish I was big enough to work at West Trek too.
Oh, pretty quiet.
Yeah, well, mine was pretty hectic, actually.
Yeah?
Couldn't believe what happened.
Welcome back to this final quarter and some bad news for our Perth viewers during the break. The Wildcats have been robbed of 2 points. The official scorers here have made a bit of a blue. They've corrected it now. They've reverted the Perth Wildcats score back to 71. The Brisbane Bullets 100, so it's even tough during the timeouts, Mike Ellis.
They even score against us when we're not playing. It's a worry, isn't it?
What about Adrian Hill?
Well, the big thing here is that the Wildcats need to salvage a little bit of pride. They've been beaten severely all over the court by the Bullets tonight. But the thing is, what happens is at the end of the season, these two teams will meet in the last game of the rounds again in Perth. Now that's going to have monumental bearings on where the teams finish in the playoffs. So the Wildcats need to get back and have this as a close game instead of something that's been a total blowout.
Carroll can't make the shot. That's a good point brought up there by Mike Ellis. The big elbow flailing away there by Crawford. The call's gone against James Crawford as Sproling gets up off court. Ricky Grace goes there to demonstrate. Billy Mildenhall.
You see, Crawford's got the ball and he's stepped right back in there to Shane Froling and give him a what call there and sent Froling flying and Eddie Crouch called the foul on James Crawford.
100 the Bullets, 71 the Perth Wildcats. Nothing going right for the Wildcats at the moment. Loggins to Gribble. Colbert gets the shot away, right on the buzzer, 102-71. Grace, Jamie Baker, single number 34, just a 19-year-old forward, Mike Ellis, a player with plenty of potential.
Certainly is. He's spent a little bit of time in the US. Jamie's come back, as I say, got a lot of potential, but very, very young. And it's, you know, he's out there to try and gain a little bit of experience and hopefully give him a bit of a spark at the moment.
Colbert. The touch goes to Froling. Froling all over the back of James Crawford. Hard to argue with that one.
closely here. Frohling goes in for the lap. Crawford picks down the big rebound here, and Shane Crawling tried to rip his head off there, but James Crawford has been very determined since he come back on in this quarter. And in the latter part of that third quarter, he's been very determined and trying to get the bit of respectability back into the Wildcats' score.
So now, a foul's been found off the ball.
Off the ball, Andre Moore is third.
So now the calls come. Players to keep their elbows down. Let's get on with the game. Crawford. He's tried hard for the Perth Wildcats. Carroll to Baker. The 19-year-old tries to go around Loggins. He'll get a second shot at it. Gribble. Just had his foot on the baseline in control of the ball. And this might just be the spark, the hiding that Wildcats are getting next week. Mike Ellis, top of the table clash with South East Melbourne.
That's exactly right, and that's a very, very big one. And, you know, the Wildcats are going to be hurting from this game, no question about it, and it'll be very interesting to see how they rebound from here.
Fisher, top of the keyway, gets a step closer, makes the two.
Scotty Fisher's been very quiet, and you won't see Scotty Fisher put too many games in a row like this.
Andre Moore scoring at will at the moment. He's up to 25 points, shooting 91% from the field.
He's the game high scorer, and he's leading Colbert 23 and Loggins on 24, so they're having a real battle.
Crawford rips down the rebound, race for three. Dribble to Shane Heal. Colt. Back to Heal. The 3 points, Shane Heal says thanks very much, Dave Fulton.
Well, that's a 34-point split now, and
getting ugly.
It is ugly, and like Mike Ellis said, they want to pull it back for that last game of the round in case they're level on points. And Perth Wildcats are making no leeway here at all. They've only scored 2 points so far in this quarter.
107 the Bullets. The Perth 73 will take a short break.
The action's hotting up. England must fight back.
How will you feel?
Presented by Ford, the fifth test.
And got him, caught ball.
Tonight.
Herb, broken fence back there.
Yes, I'll get around to it.
How's he sheep too, Herb?
Big job, dipping.
Not with Juricide backliner.
Juricide?
Juricide, the green backliner. There's nothing stronger.
Nothing stronger?
Nothing.
In 48 hours, Juricide spreads around the sheep to start killing lice and gives 10 weeks protection.
Juricide, eh?
Green Juricide.
There's nothing stronger for longer.
Retrovision has negotiated the biggest bulk buy deal in its 33-year history, and that means massive bulk buy savings on Sharp, Hoover and Vulcan Chef. Save $40 on this Sharp video, now only $429. Buy any Dishlex dishwasher and get this 42-piece stainless steel cutlery set absolutely free. And there's savings by the truckload on Chef gas and electric upright stoves. Retrovision's massive bulk buy savings must end August 23rd. Buy anywhere else and you'll pay too much.
The big crowd in here, just under 10,000 people for this clash of the arch rivals of the NBL, enjoying the battle. The Bullets, they're out by 107-73. The Perth Wildcats, really, pride now on the line, Mike Ellis.
There's no doubt about it. They've certainly got to salvage some sort of pride. And there's Ricky Grace trying to make a tough basket. Mark Catalini seeing his first time on the court, making two, so that's good for the young fella, but they need to reclaim a bit of pride here now.
They're resting Andrew Vlahov.
Yeah, Andrew's going to have a sit. I don't think you'll see Andrew back on the court today. That just symbolises the way the game's been going, doesn't it?
Fisher did keep it in. Trevor Torrance.
Well, I think it's one of the few times that the Perth Wildcats have contested a lead pass there, and Scott Fisher was the guy to do it.
Colbert, way downtown, Dave Colbert.
Colbert just comes down, makes it look so easy. When the Wildcats are working real hard to get a basket, Dave Colbert comes down, or any of the Bullets players, they come down, and it's oh so easy.
People back in Perth may say we're being in touch bias towards the Bullets, but it's hard to be any other way at the moment, Mike Ellis, with a 110-77.
Well, I don't think it's a matter of being biased, Terry. The Bullets have just certainly outplayed the Wildcats in every aspect of the game tonight. And Shane Heal is just saying the very same thing to Ricky Grace by the look of things down on the baseline there.
Been a contest now. They continue to go at it, Heal and Grace. Grace has 17 points against his name. Heal 13. Scotty Fisher, one of his best nights. We all know how great a player he is. He's the player the Bullets coach Bruce Palmer desperately wanted on his team. While there was no room in the Bullets salary cap for Scotty Fisher, there was some room in the Perth Wildcats salary cap.
I'm not coming into that one. But what's interesting out there, I was talking to some of the officials of Perth Wildcats before the game. The one player that they really wanted to stop out there from the Brisbane Bullets was Dave Colbert, and they failed to do that. Colbert, game-high scorer with 26 points. He's had a sensational game, and shooting 60%. 4 out of 6 from the three-point line, and 4 out of 4 from the foul line, Terry. And he's also taken up 4 rebounds. Dave Colbert's had a huge game, as Eddie Crouch moves in here to quieten Ricky Grace down, who's had a few words with Shane Heal.
Colbert just goes over there to console Heal.
Well, I don't think he needs too much consoling, because he's going to have 2 free throws and the ball from the side, so that seems to be enough consolidation for him.
Grace is none too happy about it as well.
The old wise man Eddie Crouch has been around a few times. He's seen a few sunrises, Eddie Crouch. He knows what's going on out there.
Heal will go to the free throw line. Shane Heal with 13 points. And that's how he stays at the moment. He's shooting 38% from the field.
Having a shocker, isn't he?
That is the lowest of all the Brisbane Bullets. That's not happy to go with Shane Heal.
From the halfway because of the intentional foul.
And now, because of the intentional foul, will be the Bullets ball, of course, the halfway line. 111-79. Could have won a bit of money on this call.
Yes, point spread betting has taken a real betting, hasn't it?
Loggins on the baseline. Can't do it for 3. Roger Smith was there again. Fisher. Watterson. Fisher. Crawford, he'll go over the top. Torrance with the rebound and the shot, can't make it. Fisher eventually tipped it in.
Shane Crawford battled hard at in a losing cause here for Wildcats, and that's the competitor James Crawford is. He just doesn't give up. You see Shane Heal hit another big jump shot there, will push the shooting percentage up, and Shane, he's had a fairly good game out there. He's ran the show very well for the Bullets.
Catalini with the turnaround jumper.
Mark Catalini, substitution.
Surprised Palmer hasn't given Blair Smith a bit of a run. Hasn't been playing too well lately, and needs a bit of confidence, and just sort of a lead. You would have thought he would have given him a bit of court time just to boost him up, but Blair Smith had a disappointing year so far.
He's played precious little time to really show his form. Season 1992, Blair Smith, like looked like he'd really come on in season 1993.
Well, it's probably unfortunate, Terry, that Dave Colbert joined the team because that was the sort of spot that Blair Smith was earmarked for. But he's going to have to work hard if he's going to take some minutes away from Dave Colbert, especially when he scores 26 points and playing the way he is. He's been a real star for the Brisbane Bullets.
The timeout has been called with the Brisbane Bullets. They're up by 113 to 83 over the Perth Wildcats. The home crowd love it. Bad news for the Perth Wildcats, Dave Colbert, who's got 26 points. You wouldn't believe it, Mike Ellis, but he had probably his worst game of the season last Sunday against the Gold Coast. I guess the Wildcats wished he would have saved that for this week.
Yeah, really. I think they wish he still was in the Gold Coast at the moment, the way he's playing tonight. I saw that game and he was struggling considerably, but boy, has he turned that around tonight. He's just done it all. He was even over here offering me some popcorn at one stage.
What about Andre Moore, Terry? Shooting 10 from 11, 91% from the field, and had 10 rebounds and 2 block shots. Just having a sensational game, Andre Moore. You couldn't criticise any of the Bullets players at all. The only player you could criticise, and he won't like me saying this, is Shane Hill shooting 43%, but he's made up with it. He's had 7 assists. He's had a great game out there for the Bullets, and every one of their players has come off the bench and really contributed, where Adrian Hurley hasn't had that luxury at all. The starters have been very spasmodic in their form, and the bench players just haven't come on and give him that lift that he would like. And but I wouldn't write the Wildcats off at this stage. Like I said, they've had a great season so far, and Adrian Hurley will get them back on the court next week, and next game they'll forget about this one, or they won't forget about it, but they'll put it in the back of their mind and get on with the job that has to be done in the future.
Mike, I don't think I'd like to participate in the next training session the Perth Wildcats have when they get back home.
Well, if they ask if I'm available, I'm afraid I've got prior engagements. There's no question about it. I think it'll be a pretty tough one. And as Curly said, you know, as long as the Wildcats can learn something out of this, they dissect it, work out where they went wrong, what they have to do to fix it, then, you know, you can get something out of it. But they certainly need to learn from the intensity that the Bullets have had on defence, I think, tonight.
Strange bringing Andrew Vlahov back on at the stage with his injury, but if I was any of the Perth Wildcats players, I wouldn't be late down the foyer in the morning for the bus to the airport, because I think they don't think Adrian Hill will be waiting for them.
Catalini down. The Wildcats with 5 minutes left. They're trying to narrow this gap the best they can. Fisher in there. Vlahov. He's had an unhappy weekend. They probably lost in the Townsville Casino as well.
Well, funnily enough, Scott Fisher had a win. He had a big win, evidently, so he was good for a loan, but I wouldn't put the bite on him tonight, that's for sure.
Maybe he doesn't need the winning bonus tonight. Torrance. Fisher.
Good strong move there from Scotty Fisher. Just posted up, Dave. Colbert held his ground, but as you see, Scott Fisher's so strong. Colbert's there, but Fisher just muscled his way up and made the basket. And that's a good lesson there for young players as well. A lot of players just want to draw the foul and not worry too much about the basket. But Scotty Fisher, he drew the foul, made the basket, and turns it into a three-point play.
A 30-point lead for the Brisbane Bullets. With 4 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. Fisher has 21 for the Perth Wildcats. Grace has 19, Crawford 18. Colbert, he's had a wow of a game for the Brisbane Bullets. Now they're away, the Wildcats. Torrance.
This is by Mark Catalini.
Heel, Luke Gribble now calling the shots. And Bruce Palmer, he wants to grind the Wildcats into the court. Not running a many of his bench players, Colbert continues to blaze away. He'll get a second chance. Good determined play there from Vlahov. Some good sportsmanship there, Colbert and Vlahov.
We're going to time out. Brisbane Bullets.
The Eagles looking to consolidate a spot in the top six on the AFL ladder. This week, they fly to Brisbane for their first game at the Gabba. 12 o'clock today, the Brisbane Bears and West Coast Eagles, live on Golden West Television.
BP Fuel to Freedom. Your chance to win some big prizes that will either get you and three friends to the Pacific Islands Club with Thai Airways International. Get you on the water on your own Yamaha Wave Runner from Choice Marine. Get you extra freedom with $15,000 cash in an R&I Visa account. Or get you out in this new Rockster four-wheel drive. Get your BP Fuel to Freedom logbook from a BP service station. Fill in your logbook and watch GWN for a chance to win your freedom. BP on the move.
Every day is a brand new experience, different every way.
I love those new wedges.
We got 320 specials, different every day. Monday.
Pretty cool for only $3.20.
This is a great deal.
Wednesday.
That's a 320 special.
Thursday and Friday, 320 special.
Every day is my day.
For the West Best Barbecue Chicken Taste. Chicken Treats.
Albany's independent farmer store on the edge of town, Peter Graham Company, gives farmers and townsfolk alike the buying edge and money savings value on general hardware lines as well as tools and plumbing supplies. And Peter Graham Company are the home gardener's friend with everything from reticulation to pine posts. Wherever you live and work, you'll appreciate their quality and value selection of clothing. Even the needs of man's best friend and other pets are at hand at Peter Graham Company, your local bloke from CRT.
I guess it's always hard to say just how much travel does affect the team as well.
Well, I mean, you know, it's always a problem. Travel is a problem. This is a big, long trip, but there's no way that the Wildcats will use as an excuse. They just haven't been up to the mark tonight. And full credit to the Bullets. They've certainly outplayed them.
Shane Neal continues to do the damage. What a set. Fisher, Vlahov, shows good strength, Andrew Vlahov.
We've got substitution, Shane Froling, Lindley Briefies, Sardis.
Now some more.
Track up Dave Coleman, Andre
the
Moore.
Bullets. Get a go, Blair Smith. On court, the Brisbane Bullets along with Lyndon Briefies. Chance for Palmer to play some of the bench players. Turnover, Catalini. Foul called on Gribble.
Catalini made a strong drive. You just see here, Luke Gribble. Yeah, probably a little bit unlucky there, Luke Gribble, unless he got him with his body, but he had a hand on the ball there. And irrespective, Catalini will have two foul shots. You see the Bullets, we see Lyndon Briefies on now and Nigel Burton. So we've got all the skins out there now. None of the starters from the Bullets are on. So, interesting now. Let's see if the Wildcats can peg back a few points here.
...117-91, the Brisbane Bullets, they lead the Perth Wildcats. 3 minutes and 14 seconds remaining. The bench players now on court for the Brisbane Bullets. They've got plenty to play for. Virgin, Frolling, in there, scrapping for the ball. He comes away with it. Lyndon Briefies, he'll take a two-point shot. And makes his first of the night, Lyndon Briefies.
Yeah, Lee shooting 100% as well.
Gets to see precious little court time, Lyndon Briefies. Fisher. They're just not dropping for the Wildcats. Catalini showed some good skills since he's been on.
He only shot 3 out of 3, Terry, and 2 out of 2 from the foul line, and throwing a couple of rebounds. Not a bad effort from the youngster. And what's his background, Mike?
Well, he's a local boy, Curly. He's only about 19 years old, very young guy. Great athlete. He's got the same vertical leap as Crawford, which is no mean feat by anyone, I can tell you that right now. Just plays at the local club for Coburn, and he's got some great potential. I think he's going to be a real player.
Wattison, Catalini.
Yeah, well, he's caught that fast break there and took that jump. You see a travel being called here on Luke Gribble. And he does. He looks like he has got some talent out there, the youngster. And
battling away, and you're right, he does definitely look like an athlete out there. And I was just watching Lyndon Brief, he's there before. He may not have played much, Terry, but he's going to make up for those minutes he hasn't played by getting some shots in these last 2 minutes.
Yeah, no one else is going to see the ball. Not up, not in, eh?
That's right.
Whiteison. Now, Carroll can't do it. Frolling, the big rebound. Dribble, brings the ball up court. Bergen. Only one of the young guns of the Brisbane Bullets. Gribble can't do it. Blair Smith, an easy 2 points for him. 1 minute, 48 seconds remaining. 121 to 96. Charge. Called on. Catalini.
His first.
Now Ricky Grace comes back on court.
Well, we have two interesting subs there. Ricky Grace on for the Wildcats and Shane Heal on for the Bullets. Coaches do some funny things out there.
Heal. Bergen. Back to Heal. Shane Frolling, the backdoor play. He missed. Shane Frolling just stuck. Don't worry, I'll take it out of myself, he says.
He just can't understand how he missed such an easy shot here. He's all over him here. There's a foul call there, but the one before it, he should have made it with his eyes closed. He's that open.
It's been a big effort by the Brisbane Bullets. Led from the very word go. Shane Frolling. I bet you he's glad they're leading by 121 to 96.
I'll ask you this question, Terry. How come Nigel Purchase hasn't suited up tonight?
Well, Purchase has a bad ankle at the moment. He's been out. He had it earlier in the season. He's done it again. He's had a very unhappy season since he's made the move up from the Melbourne Tigers. And he spoke very well at the Bullets lunch the other night.
Trying to find it hard getting back, getting some minutes after this performance tonight from the Bullets, as we see Shane Frolling go to the foul line once more.
Nigel Purchase has been working on his suntan since he's been up here. In fact, I think in his whole history in the NBL, he'd never missed a game through injury until this season. So the Brisbane fans here, I've seen precious little really of Nigel Purchase.
Well, this is the first quarter that the Bulls have been outscored. Wildcats have scored them by three in this quarter, so they want to try and get out there and square that up.
Heels out there to keep the Bullets on track. Burke goes past Baker, gets the shot up. Nigel Bergen gets on the scoreboard with 2 points.
Well, they've all scored except Luke Gribble.
Inside the 42-second mark now. Bergen goes to battle there. Grace. Fisher kicks it out to Baker. Baker for three. No good. Heels away. Bergen's with him behind the back.
Travel.
It's all good experience for Bergen. Laho.
It's probably a little unkind of Shane Heal saying it's the worst shooting percentage in the team tonight. Luke Gribble's 0 from 1, so Shane, he picked me up on that, so I better make sure we get the record straight here.
Sorry, Terry, I was just about to say, you'd have a hard time picking an MVP for the Bullets tonight, wouldn't you?
You certainly would.
It's a tough choice, isn't it? Colbert, 26 points. Loggins, 24. Andre Moore with 27 points. You'd be close to my MVP.
Everybody!
Shane Heal, we're inside 17-second mark remaining. Shane Frolling can't miss from there. inside. 9 seconds left. It's been a demolition by the Brisbane Bullets. Final second. The Wildcats, they still can't score. The demolition has been completed by the Brisbane Bullets. They've toppled the NBL pace setters, the Perth Wildcats. And what a job they've done on the Wildcats. 126-97. Brian Curl, it's a shock.
Well, it certainly was. I favoured the Bulls before the game, but no way did I think they'd win by 29 points tonight. It has been a great all-round performance. There was no weaknesses from anyone from the whole team. Their starters, right down to the bench, everybody contributed. Bruce Palmer called all the shots and the players delivered for him. Whereas Adrian Hurley, just nothing went right for Adrian Hurley out there. His players let him down, but don't write him off. They had a tough one last night. There's no excuse, I know. And they'll be ready for next week's game, and Adrian Hurley will make sure of that.
The Perth Wildcats, don't worry, they'll be back to fight another day. There is absolutely no doubt about that. Leroy Loggins, he was able to enjoy a rest there late in that final quarter. He's now with Mike Ellis.
Well, Leroy, that was a great game. The burning question is, what did you guys eat before tonight's game?
We didn't eat anything. It was just a lot of hard training. We prepared well for this game, and we just came out and played the way we were supposed to play, the way Bruce instructed us to play, and things went our way.
Well, they certainly did. You came out shooting very, very well, but I think the defense is where you won the game. You worked specifically on that this week?
Well, we try to base our game on defense anyway. You know, sometimes it doesn't work for us, but I thought tonight we did a great job.
There's no question you certainly pushed the Wildcats a bit out of everything they're trying to do. Where to from here, mate?
We got a game next week. I'm not sure who it is. I'm just so excited about the win, but it's back to the drawing board for us. We can't get carried away with this win. You know, it's a long season and anything can happen.
All right, Lee, I'll let you go get a well-earned drink, mate. Well done. Back to you, Tito.
Thanks very much, Mike Ellis and Leroy Loggins. Just for the record, the Brisbane Bullets play Adelaide next Saturday night. What a demolition it's been. We'll be back after this break with a quick wrap-up.
O'clock this afternoon, baseball fever hits town when Goofy and Donald Duck star in an hour of cartoon fun. It's a salute to America's national pastime in the wonderful world of Disney. Today on GWM.
Broken fence back there.
Yes, I'll get around to it.
Lousy sheep too,
Big job, dipping.
Not with Juricide backliner.
Juricide?
Juricide, the green backliner. There's nothing stronger.
Nothing stronger?
Nothing.
In 48 hours, Juricide spreads around the sheep to start killing lice and gives 10 weeks protection.
Juricide, eh?
Green Juricide.
There's nothing stronger for longer.
Cullity Timbers. Your WA resource-backed company. If you're building or renovating, come to where the tradesmen shop. We'll help you make it. Or recommend a professional. So start with Cullity Timbers. You'll get the best and still save.
Well, what a ball over in the end. A demolition job by the Brisbane Bullets on the Perth Wildcats. Brian Curl, a big surprise.
Well, the win wasn't a surprise to me, but the way they did it was just sensational. The defence was the best defence I've seen from the Brisbane Bullets. Probably, I can't say ever, because I thought they played a few good games for me, but overall the defence was just unbelievable. The shooting percentage was great. The whole team, everybody contributed, and geez, that makes coach's job very easy when that happens.
And I'm sure when we have a look at the stats, that field goal percentage shooting will be the telling factor. 62% by the Brisbane Bullets. Well, it'd take a very good side to beat them on a night like tonight.
Yeah, 62%. And Terry, one thing about that didn't vary too much for the whole game. And foul shooting was 70%. That dropped down a little bit, but 47 from the three-point line. They won on the boards. Turnovers, well, that was the only area that Wildcats won on. You see the top scorers here, Andre Moore. I think he shot something like 91% for that 27 points, which was great shooting. Colbert 26, Loggins 24, hadn't trained all week. Heal 18, Roger Smith 13. And look at the Wildcats, Terry.
Well, Fisher 21 and Grace 19 and Crawford 18, they all tried hard along with Vlahov
who was hampered with that bad ankle, but in the end it just wasn't good enough, was it?
Well, it wasn't, and Andrew Blah will be very disappointed, but the Wildcats have put that behind them. They've got Southeast Melbourne Magic next week at home, and they know the pressure's on them, and that was a real test tonight for the Brisbane Bullets.
From Brian Curl, myself and all the crew out here at Boondall, have a very good evening.
This NBL telecast, proudly presented by Westrac Equipment, Country Holden Dealers proudly sponsoring WA Sports, and Chicken Treat.
I got the taste.
Jeff Marsh.
I've seen our Holden test rodeo.
Spot on the NBL ladder after last night's hammering at the hands of the Brisbane Bullets. After jumping to an early lead, the Bullets were never seriously challenged, leading at every change. Last night's loss was the end of an eight-game winning streak for the Cats.
Brisbane's three-point game was working to perfection in the opening period. Fatigued from Friday's game and the road trip, the Cats were forced to play catch-up, but some great defence was making it difficult.
Roger Smith streaks away. Got to make the duck.
And the three-pointers just continued to drop.
And he makes it.
11 points up at the break, the second period saw the long stuff continue as the visitors tried to peg back the deficit. Loggins was inspirational as plays like this saw the Queenslanders score 70 points.